I wanna hear your thoughts, I wanna hear your sound. And mama always told me to shout and speak my mind out loud.
Come on and talk when you got the time. Freedom, what you want to learn? We wanna hear from you.
You got a gun.
Let your voice shine. Platform yours is not just mine. We wanna hear from you.
You got a gun.
Talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, talk to me.
Hey y'all, what's up? It's your boy Douglas, or you could call me Freedom. Welcome to my channel. Before we get started, make sure that you guys like this video, comment below this video, share this video, and subscribe to my channel because you need me. I know I've been gone for a minute. I had a lot of exams. School's really been holding your boy by the neck, so forgive me. You know I'm gonna always come back and serve. I always do. I do got a breakfast burrito because I did not eat all day and it is late. If you haven't already, make sure that you listen to Cinnamon Girl Remix and Bebe's Freestyle Part 2. In the last episode, I kind of told you guys that what I was doing as far as a small project was scrapped. It's back on the table, but I don't want to actually, you know, make anything concrete without actually being sure about it. So stay tuned because there is music and stuff coming. I am working on a good amount of stuff. I got some awesome guests with me today. As I say always, make sure you guys forgive my background and forgive my brother. And without further ado, I think we could get started. All right, y'all. This is our first segment, Freedom of Speech. This is going to be really quick because we really want to get into our game.
My name is Tati. My Instagram is I am Tati with 4 I's underscore. My pronouns, she, her. That's it. That's it.
I'm Kina, and the Instagram name is As You See It Here, and my pronouns are she, her.
The first thing I wanted to talk to you guys about was the world we live in. Did y'all feel that earthquake?
I did. I know you didn't feel it.
That's the gag. I was outside hours prior to it because I had a doctor's appointment. I was already outside. I was on my way home and I was walking into my building and Claudia FaceTimed me and she was like, yo, we just had an earthquake. I'm like, Claudia, what? Like, what? Like, we just had an earthquake. Like, my bed shook and everything. I'm like, Claudia, what the hell are you talking about? Because I've been outside for, like, at that point, I was outside for a good hour and change. I was like, Claudia, no, what are you talking about? Like, I didn't even want to entertain it because in my mind, I was like, you probably had a bad dream or you probably just, ha. So in my mind, I was like, it's probably nothing. I was like, girl, and as soon as I was about to tell her to stop smoking, tell me why a construction worker come out. He like, hey, did you feel that? I'm like, what the, feel what? What are you? And he was like, my coworkers just said that there was an earthquake, but I didn't feel nothing. I was like, I did not feel nothing either. I've been outside for an hour and change. Then as soon as I turned to my left, the elevator door opened. It's my aunt, my cousins coming. Naya, shout out to Naya. Naya woke up to me. She like, you felt that? I'm like, yo, felt what? And everybody in the elevator was like, it was an earthquake. We getting the fuck out of here. I'm like, what do you mean that earthquake? Like, I did not feel nothing. The construction workers was on the roof. They didn't feel nothing. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Like, it must be me. Then you call me. You like, did you feel that? I'm
like, and you know the phone. I don't know what happened, but the phones went down for like a quick second. Because when I tried to call, it was like the call fail for like 2 minutes or a couple minutes. Because my coworker, she was trying to call whoever, and her phone was not working.
And then Suki called me. Shout out to Suki. Suki called me at work. She was like, the whole school shook. She was out to pack her shit and dip.
Yeah, my whole job shook. I was talking to my boss, and we was literally talking face-to-face. And I'm like, did you feel that? She's like, no. I'm like, how didn't you just feel that? The whole tables were shaking and everything. We're literally talking. We're in the same. And I tell you that the desk was shaking, everything. Like, you don't, at least you ain't feel it. Did you see it? Like, she's like, no.
Well, y'all already know I live in the trenches. So these buildings right here, the earthquake, these buildings are done. Like, done.
See, that's the shit that woke me up. I was sleeping and I woke up to shaking. Like, I was so disoriented. Like, that was just such a weird feeling to wake up to that. Like, what?
What's so crazy to me is how you really have your people that felt it and then you have your people that didn't.
Like, I didn't feel a thing. And one of my neighbors I was talking to, she told me that she didn't feel a thing either. And in my mind, I'm like, okay, this is kind of weird because if it was an earthquake, we should have all felt it. How is it that some people felt it, some people didn't? And it really brought me back to the little aftermath of an earthquake we had back in 2010. And I remember that shit solidly because it was one of the most embarrassing days of my life. We're not gonna get into it, but I got stuck in the swing for real. I remember watching Maury, and as soon as the results came out, as soon as the chick found out that like the guy that she thought was her baby father was her baby father, girl, oh no, I think it was a lie detector test results because I think the guy was cheating. Whatever happened, the results did not come out in her favor, and she went crazy. And as soon as like she went crazy, and the audience started yelling and screaming, bitch, the floor started shaking. I'm like, hold on, like I'm like. And I just remember like everybody in my house was just panicking, and then my brother's home attendant at the time, like she was just panicking, like she thought we was gonna fucking. Thank God, Tuna was like already like midway through a bath. We got him out, we got him dressed, we all just threw on the first clothes we could see, and we got out of there. But it was my Uncle Ray's birthday party. May he rest in peace. It was my Uncle Ray's birthday party later on that day, and we went to this little park situation that we had like the cookout at. And my cousin dared me to like, get into the swings or whatever, because she was real skinny. So she got her little petite self in and out. But me, I was stuck in the swing. And it took a good 20, 30 minutes to get me out of the baby swing. Cause we put ourselves in the baby swing.
Oh
Yeah, and I was already a little thick, really.
no.
I already had my little turkey thighs by the time I was six. So girl, I tell you, them legs got locked into that baby swing. Locked in bad boots. They said that it was a 4.5 magnitude earthquake. I don't.
Yeah, like
This
a
one
four
was
point eight.
4.8. I don't feel like a 4.8 would have did us big dirty.
I don't think we got the 4.8. I think we got like half of that. But I heard it was worse in Jersey. I think
Yeah.
Jersey.
They said something about people losing their lives, if I'm not mistaken.
No.
Breaking pipes.
In Jersey, not here, I don't think.
No, Jersey.
No way. There's no way.
I literally saw it on my aunt's TV. Like we was watching the
No.
news and they was talking about all the damage that happened in Jersey.
That's
It was
terrible.
ridiculous. I was like, oh my God. Like I didn't know it really didn't. I don't remember it hitting us. Look, New York would have been done. That's what I'm telling y'all. Like New York would have been all the coastal areas would have been done. I just don't know. It didn't hit like a 4.8 at least. I don't know where it came from. I remember reading somewhere that the earthquake was actually in Japan.
Taiwan.
Taiwan,
Yeah.
China. Wow. I did not know that. Wow, that's crazy. Well, y'all already know Doomsday coming, right? So y'all gotta
I
prep.
just I want to just be like,
That ain't going.
yeah, of old age.
Yes.
Nah, we talked about Doomsday last season. All I gotta say is the clock is motherfucking ticking, okay? Regardless of who president, just so y'all know. All right, y'all, moving on to our next topic, because I really want to get to this fucking game. There's women getting punched in this city?
Yes.
Multiple women have reported being punched in the face in New York City, and their stories are all over TikTok. Here's what we know. A series of women have been posting alarming TikTok reports about being randomly punched by a stranger while walking in New York, including at least two daylight attacks reported to cops this week. Social media influencer Hallie Kate posted a clip after she was struck in broad daylight.
You guys, I was literally just walking and a man came up and punched me in the face. Oh my God, it hurts so bad. I can't even talk. Literally, I fell to the ground and now this giant goose is forming and I'm like, oh my God, it looks so crazy.
Since Kate's viral video was uploaded online on Monday morning, multiple other women have now echoed her claims to say they have been victims as well.
There's been a series of women on TikTok going on TikTok saying that they've been hit, like as they're coming out of stores
Punched.
and shit. First of all, it's white women being hit. I
It
don't even need
is. Yeah.
It's white women being hit.
It
They know not to go to no black bitch and hit them. Definitely not no Bronx. Definitely
Right.
not no East New York. Definitely, they know where to go.
When I was watching them TikToks, I'm like, well, they know where to go. They know who to go to because.
They will get gathered out here. Girl, there's no such thing as just hitting a girl for no ass reason.
I know. And so there was this black woman who made a TikTok and she was like, I just ran into the guy who keeps doing it And he knows not, he knew not to hit me because she had walked by him.
I hope he hit the right female. They going to dummy his ass up too.
That's what I'm saying. He know who to hit because I'm not going to cry.
Girl!
I'm not going to cry and I'm not going to make it.
Shit.
I'm not going to jail.
I'm going to jail. Like, yeah. It's just that simple.
And that just makes him even more weak because you really praying on the weak. Like, you're not going to hit certain people because you know they're going to hit your ass back.
Girl, go to Harlem. Mm-hmm. Go to Pickin' and Zmart.
Go to Harlem and try that shit.
Please, go to the Bronx, girl.
Go to Brownsville and try
Go to Bed-Stuy. Go to Marcy. Please go to Pink Houses. What? Please.
He's not going to
Please. I don't know if it's if they're doing it for a trend or if they just have like this specific disdain for white chicks, but I don't know. All women, y'all need to protect yourselves big time.
Mm-hmm.
Invest in the tasers. I told my friends this. Invest in the tasers, pocket knives, whatever weapons y'all could legally
carry because
yeah,
it's ridiculous out here. Remember the situation that happened to me the other day?
I was actually going to tell you to get into it if you wanted to, but yeah.
Yeah. So one morning I was driving my kids to school and it was this stupid, I mean, I'm pretty sure a lot of people could relate to having a little bit of road rage. He did some stupid nonsense in the street. I'm like, what is he doing? I literally did that Facebook. I'm like, what is he doing? And I kept moving. Why, when I pull up to my kid's school, he's pulling up beside me. Mm-hmm. Like, follow me, pulled up beside me. And I'm like, what the hell? So I pulled up more, and he pulled up beside me again, and he rolled his window down, and he was like, "Do we got beef? We got beef?" This is a black man, by the way, a young black man. Yes. He's like, "Do we got beef?" I'm like, "What?" He's like, "Do we got beef? Do we got beef?" Whatever, mind you, his posture, the way he was like sitting, he had his hand in his lap, and I'm like, I don't know, something in me felt like he had something on him. So I rolled my window up and I drove off. He was following me and I'm driving. He's speeding up following me. I pulled up by the NYPD car and that nigga turned immediately. So I had to get out with my kids and I told them what happened and they were like, okay, we're going to follow you to the school so I could drop them off. And then they followed me home to make sure.
I believe in a black woman and you know that's rare as fuck. They must have been having a good day.
Right? It was two men. They looked like one was Hispanic, one was white. And I told him, like, I didn't get out the car, you know, because I felt like I got out the car when he pulled up beside me. He would have probably, is everything in me told me he was going to harm me. Like, he was going to, you know, he had something in his hand. Maybe he had a gun. Maybe he had a knife. I don't know. Yeah, but everything in me told me, like, he was going to harm me because I done cursed out men before. You know, it could have gone bad. I done cursed men out and everything like that. But in that moment, I'm like, it didn't feel right for me to get out and take my kids into school. Then he kept following me. But the police officers, they follow me back to my kids' school. I dropped them off. Then they follow me back home to make sure he wasn't following me no more. And that was my morning. And that was all at 8 a.m.
Yo.
Like,
he had time.
For real, because I'm like,
what a shit, apparently.
Was it that serious?
I was on the phone with you when everything happened.
Yeah.
Like, it was just that. And Kina, didn't you also tell me something about you? A man had followed you into a store?
He was the one of those guys that's like asking you, like, oh, can you sign this for our basketball camp or whatever? And then.
Remember that episode of SVU?
Uh oh.
We Lord and Order Girlies in the chat. Lord and Order Girlies in the chat.
Actually, an episode on SVU. It was this man. He was raping women by doing that. He was getting their information, letting them.
Yeah, making
for
them
sign like
petition.
I think they were signing name, the email, whatever. He find them and then he goes them.
That's so scary. I mean, because the guy, this is right after that happened to that twin sister who from Brooklyn passed away.
That literally popped up in my head immediately. I'm like, this shit just happened. Not that scenario, but it's like,
that's why I was scared to say something.
Vibe doing me a harm for turning a man down for a man being weird. And I actually heard of that motherfucker that took the life of the girl. He actually had a history of just being really weird towards women.
Yes,
really volatile and just. he had a history of just like he was always like lurking in group chats, being a creep. Like he mm-hmm. was just a creepy ass nigga. Like
because a lot of girls came out and was like, you know, I remember seeing him at a party and he was being a little too physical, unwillingly. Of you know, they didn't want him touching him. He yeah. harmed both of them, both of the sisters, but one. They were twin sisters. Yeah. One, the other one survived, but he harmed both of them.
Like she got to live the rest of her life without her fucking twin.
Without her twin. Mm. Every day I come back to the meme that I saw when it's when some man obviously wrote the meme and he was like, oh, if woman hates us so bad and we didn't exist, then who's going to protect them? Protect us from who?
Y'all?
I know.
Because men are the problem.
Because you're exactly because you're the problem.
Yo, one of my brother's friends, no shade to him. I'm not even going to say his name. That nigga one day tried to goat me into a debate and tried to tell me what problems have men caused existing on this planet. I told you, we'll be here all day and I got to go to work.
I think it was during like the Trump debate or something when he was like, he said some stupid shit like when him and Hillary was... He was like, oh, women are emotional. They're going to start wars or whatever. Mind you, it's been nothing but men, president.
Mm-hmm. And the wars. Men forever. Starting wars. Girl.
Like, who started those wars?
Men.
Your mama?
Like, men. And every time we kept going back and forth, the answer just kept ended up being men. Like, I was just like, who did it? Men. To like, men did it, period.
School y'all, shooters, what? Men.
Men are the problem, period. I'm putting that in caps. Seriously, rest in peace to that girl. Condolences to her whole family. That is crazy. Like, Kina, remember me, you and Deborah did the whole podcast about protecting Black women after Shanquella yeah. Roberts was, y'all gotta carry weapons, period. I'm saying, Kina, sorry, I interrupted you. You didn't even get to finish your story.
It was basically just, he was, you know, he asked me to sign a petition and then I walked into the beauty supply store. And I'm just, like, not even thinking. And he comes inside, and I'm already, like, in some aisle. And he's like, oh, but, like, can I still get your number, though? And I was like, no. And he was just like, why not? You got a boyfriend? I was like, yeah. And then he was just like, oh, but, like, we could just be friends. I don't know. He was like, oh, I have girlfriends, so it don't matter. And I was like, yeah, okay. I don't have boyfriends. I don't feel like that's fair to him. So it's like, even when I'm being hit on, I find the need to like appeal to like,
yeah,
men's that's standards, like of respect, like, oh, I don't want your number because I have a boyfriend. He wouldn't like that. Like, I can't just say like, I just don't want your number. Like, it's so crazy. So then I called my mom and I was just like, damn, now I'm thinking about that girl. Like
I was in the store the other day and the same thing happened. He was like, oh, can I have your number or whatever? I'm like, no, I have a boyfriend. No thanks. Still lingering there. He's like, I thought he left the store. And then he circled mm-hmm. back around. He's like, oh, I can't leave without nothing. Like, I'm like, no, I'm good. Thanks. He's still going. He's like, mm-hmm. can't Instagram something. We don't gotta have your number. We could just be friends on it, whatever, whatever. I'm like, no, I'm good. Thanks. And he kept going. Mm-hmm. Like, man, I can't leave with just whatever. Mm-hmm. So I gave him my Instagram and I blocked him. Like,
period.
That's so
the only reason I caved in to doing that is because when you think back to everything, this thing that just happened with this girl and so many other cases of women getting or assaulted because they just say no.
And the thing is that even with your number, if you had given her your number, my cousin the other day, she got stopped by this guy and his friend. They asked for her number. She was trying to walk away after she gave them the number. And the friend was like, wait, you gotta call the number first. Like, you gotta make sure she's not lying. I was like, wow. That's this is what they're resorting to? Like,
get classes. I don't give a damn. Weapons. You fucking name it. You don't know.
Yeah, I'm gonna do self-defense classes.
Because these men are out of control. I don't know what
it is. I actually used self-defense on my ex one time. I had watched a video of how to get out of it. Like, you know, somebody holding you against the wall. Mm. And it actually worked, y'all. I was shook. Like, I've never been able to overpower him.
Let me find out. It's who I think it is. Because I would have sworn.
It definitely is. It most definitely. Wait, that was old, though. That was... He was way stronger than me. And you wouldn't think so, but he was way stronger than me.
I would have. That under the trash can. Sua. Like.
Men.
Gone.
Men.
God. At the end of the day, it's men. Men like, yo, shout out to Naya. In the words of Naya, men like to take advantage of women. That's it. The weather acting inconsistent is giving men. Like, bro, I saw that meme yesterday. That shit had me weak. Especially when you have men that obviously they don't know what no is. You know, to a lot of these niggas, no mean yes. So it's like it's hard to communicate and shit like that with niggas. Yeah. Like I said,
I have so many stories. I'll never forget the day. I think I was like 17. I was in the McDonald's in the morning time before school, and I had to beat a nigga with my umbrella because he would not leave me alone.
Wow.
And that was very brave of me, because now I wouldn't even end up doing that, because I'm like, he could fucking kill me. But I don't know, I was young and he was annoying. Oh my God. It was raining that morning, so I had the big umbrella and I was just I beat his ass. And it was an older guy. He was like 30 or 40. Like, bro, leave me alone. I'm a little girl.
Enough of that, because we'll be here all motherfucking podcast.
With these men, yeah.
The Freedom Savage podcast will be right back after these messages.
I wish I knew how I can fall in love all over again. Someone to see how I feel. Someone to hold me down, to show me that heaven's real. Things I wanna say to you.
Did somebody call for the Don Dada? For all my New Yorkers out there that need their hair did, my girl Lily does weaves, braids, locks, ponytails, and natural hairstyles. You don't even need to leave the comfort to wherever you at. She'll come straight to you. DM Lily on Instagram at dream.styles1 to discuss pricing and all other inquiries. Hey y'all, what's up? It's your boy Douglas, or you could call me Freedom. I am proud to announce that my official website is now up and running. Yes, you heard me here. My official website is up and running, freedomsavageentertainment.net. This website took forever, a lot of planning, a lot of creativity. Make sure you guys subscribe to my website for updates on anything that I'm doing, and you guys will still see changes made to it over time. All of the links to all of my stuff is on the website. It's gonna basically be my creative hub, and I can't wait to, you know, show you guys how this empire that I have will develop over time. All right, make sure y'all head to the website, because it's definitely giving what it's supposed to. Peace out.
Turn on your mics. We're back with the Freedom Savage podcast.
Anyway, yeah, my throat is, I need Chinese food.
What?
What?
Your throat. Can you clarify?
Where does that correlate?
How about some water, lemon water, lime, right. Hot water? Tea with Chinese food. The Chinese pork and rice.
Like, damn, my throat hurt. I need some Chinese food.
Like, I've never heard that.
That's crazy, Douglas. I'm not gonna lie.
Are you gonna order Chinese food now?
Yeah. That's a real fat bitch. All right, you guys, this is Freedom of Speech Part 2, but you already know we're playing a game. We are in the Savage Court. Now, just like last episode with me and Tati, we are going to be reviewing cases. So I'm really excited for us to get into it. And without further ado, we're going to get into our first case.
Cohen versus California is another First Amendment Freedom of Speech case that was decided by the United States Supreme Court in 1971. Very interesting set of facts. So let me explain it to you. I'm going to carefully walk around the community guidelines and make sure we're following them. Okay, thank you, TikTok. So here's the facts. we've got a 19-year-old male, and he did not appreciate the draft. Now, this again was 1971, so we've got some draft issues going on in the U.S. at the time. So his way of expressing his dissatisfaction or his reasoning that he didn't like this was he had worn a jacket that had a bad word on it and then the draft. You can fill in the bad word. It was printed on the back of his jacket. And he decided to just walk through the Los Angeles County Courthouse wearing this jacket. He was arrested and charged with disturbing the peace with offensive conduct. All right, so he was actually sentenced to 30 days in jail for this offense. Now, he appealed. Again, we've got a First Amendment issue here, freedom of speech. And the U.S. Supreme Court came back and said, no, he should not have been charged. That the word on the back of his jacket was not directed towards any one person in particular, and there was no evidence that would show that the language on his jacket would incite people to go forward and do some kind of physical action. In other words, the court set out coverage of two different kinds of speeches. First, the expression of emotion, which is emotive speech, and the expression of ideas, which is cognitive speech. So within this particular case, they broadened what speech is protected. And in the end, his conviction was overturned.
They said something about the drafts. Was that draft, like they talking about the army?
Yeah, like I guess so during that year, they had like a whole draft pick or something. I had to look it up, but it was probably a war going on. He didn't like the idea of the draft and everything. So he went to, I think it was LA court, and he had F the draft on the back of his jacket, and he walked around with F the draft.
If y'all were the judges in the case, Judge Kena, Judge Tati, we giving him guilty, not guilty? What's the gag?
Not guilty.
Not guilty.
Next.
This is a country where we could like openly talk trash about our government and shit.
Yeah.
Like, but I know in like certain countries you can't do that. Like, it's illegal to talk bad about the government or just like their processes and like what they do, like the army and shit. But like out here, you could. And like, I feel like many people have like their own objections and shit about like the army.
Yeah.
The army isn't perfect. I don't know what was going on around that time. I don't think it was big enough for him to. He got arrested, I think.
He had to do 30 days.
Them cops was bored as
that really blew my mind. I'm just like, that's just ridiculous. Like it's like any curse word is literally just made up of letters like any other word. Like whatever. Like it's never that serious. And like being able to protest the government, I think that we are very lucky to be able to, because like in my home country, like you can't do that, and they're the same person has been in power for like the last 40 years in Eritrea. And you can't speak out against him, or like you could literally be put into the army and things like that, or you know, worse.
Wow.
So I think we are just very lucky to have that, because
he appealed it, and I guess they
overturned
they found that. So from that case is when they made a distinguish of what kind of freedom of speech should be like illegal and fine. If it's freedom of speech and it's like you're doing it that way, whether you're wearing a shirt or jacket or a poster or whatever, and it has to make sure that it doesn't like affect a crowd of people to do violence.
Yeah, so like fight a riot.
Yeah, as long as it's not starting a riot, basically, then it's fine, which... what he had on did not, you know.
And they forgot to add racism in that bitch, because it was a lot of mother racist ass white people we was dealing with last episode, hanging up Confederate flags and shit. Y'all forgot to write that shit down.
Speaking of Confederate flags, I've been watching this show. Well, this documentary is on Netflix. It's called The Innocence Files. And they're basically talking about people who have been falsely accused, falsely convicted. Why in one of the case, the first episode in the case, it was in Mississippi, racist, and the court itself had a Confederate flag, in the courtroom.
Oh my God.
And the way they convicted the two black men was based off of teeth marks. Come to find out, they weren't even teeth marks. It was this, I think they're called odontologists who study teeth marks. And he like basically said on the stand, like, is no way that anyone else could have killed these girls but this man. Like, you know, he is a racist himself. They were interviewing him and he had Confederate flag mugs, Confederate flags in his office, Confederate flags in the courtrooms.
Oh my God.
Down in Mississippi.
That shit sound rigged as fuck.
Very rigged.
Very rigged.
They made an investigation into that odontologist, and he, so far, he has put away 9 people.
Oh my God, that means that they're gonna have to reopen all
a lot of things that he did,
because he definitely did it out of bias.
Falsely saying like, oh no, the teeth marks match.
Wait, when was
this? Come to find out, I think that case happened in the 80s.
Oh,
and you know, back then it's racist now, but back then it was worse. He did it twice. It was this one man. It was this little girl. She got snatched out of her bed at night and was, and he said it was teeth marks on her. Come to find out, after the little girl was like discarded, the killer put her in the lake, like threw her in the lake. The bite marks that were on her were from the fish. But he said it was this man that did it, which was the boyfriend.
You could easily tell. A good ME could easily tell fish bites.
Human and fish, yeah. Then about, he got convicted. About 6 months later, it happened again to another 3-year-old girl. Mind you, they had a suspect list for both cases. One man was on the same suspect list, and they let him go. He wound up being the actual killer.
Oh, my God.
So they had the killer the whole time. They was
So for the second girl,
fucking racism.
Yes, for the second girl, he said that mom's current boyfriend did it. So both of the mom's boyfriends went to jail for like 17 years.
17 years?
Mm-hmm.
I would have seen the fuck out of them too.
Now, mind you, during that time, they didn't have like DNA. They both were, they only had DNA from the first girl, from whoever. They matched it to the guy that was on the suspect list. And you know what they said? They didn't even let him out right away. It's like, okay, just he didn't, you know, them, but that doesn't mean he didn't kill her.
Exactly.
Oh,
I'm like, what?
That's ridiculous.
That is actually crazy, but it reminds me a lot of George Stinney, who was a 14-year-old who was sent to the electric chair for quote unquote a white girl. And
wasn't he like the first or the youngest?
The youngest.
For the death penalty, who actually did
die. They had to put like books on the chair so that he could fit inside the helmet for the like it broke my heart. It really broke my heart, that whole case. Like, I cried my eyes out, like, after watching. So it's just stuff like that really infuriates me, and that's why I asked you when that was, because the George Sitting thing was like in the 40s, I think.
Yeah, that was like in the 80s. The case and after
that's
that
crazy.
Oh, and the end of it, when they were freed, they only got $50,000 each for 10 years. I just don't feel like that's enough. Taxes is going to eat that up.
Yeah, definitely.
That's not enough. Not enough to, like, you know, $50K like for 10 years. So you only get $50K a year before taxes.
Wow.
And then the episode after that, it happened to a white man in the South. He got falsely imprisoned because of the teeth bite mark thing, when it wasn't him. But when he was freed, he got $23 million.
Wow.
$1 million for each year he was in prison.
Oh my God.
He got enough for generational wealth. Like, $50K a year before taxes for only 10 years.
Black people are still asking for restitution money and shit.
Yeah.
All of that, because we definitely need it.
And it's sad, because when you watch that episode, the way these girls were taken, the houses they were in were plantation houses. Like, it was down in Mississippi, so a lot of the black community still lived on plantations. Their houses were plantation houses. They were really small. The windows were messed up. The doors don't lock. Like, it looked real, very ragged. He got $23 million. I was like, I feel bad that he was falsely imprisoned, but they deserved this just as much. Like,
yeah.
Yes.
But they didn't even want to let them out. like I told you, they were like, oh, they didn't kill him, but they didn't rape him, but, you know, they had to kill him. They didn't even want to let them out of prison. They didn't want to say that they were wrong.
Yeah. She's not built for our success, our well-being, our health.
I'm like, that white man got enough for generational wealth. He could pass money down, property down if he buys it, houses down if he buys it. What these men got?
Nothing.
After $50,000 a year and taxes taken, I make that much a year. Like, even though it was back then, it was a lot, but still.
This is Justice Brennan, and he sat on the Warren Courts, and he wrote the opinion for a very famous case called Mishkin v. New York. And this case was decided in 1965, and it has to do with obscenity and the First Amendment. Here's what happened. In New York City, police officers had arrested a publisher, and they did some investigation into the kind of materials he was publishing and found that there were multiple books that had covers on them depicting certain kinds of fetishes that were inappropriate under the New York statute obscenity law. So he was charged with multiple counts. He was charged with possessing obscene books, with hiring others to prepare obscene materials, as well as publishing obscene materials. He appealed. Now, his sentence was changed a little bit by one of the appellate courts, primarily because there was a requirement that he list his name and address on his materials, and this piece of the New York law was held unconstitutional. But other than that, everybody agreed the sentence was fine. He appealed up to the United States Supreme Court. Of course, we've got a lot of questions here on the First Amendment, but here are the three primary questions for the U.S. Supreme Court. Number one, was New York's anti-obscenity statute impermissibly vague? And the answer, Justice Brennan said, was no. There might be some terms used here that you don't normally see, but they weren't vague. They were pretty descriptive. Number two, were Mishkin's books properly found to be obscene under the Roth test? Justice Brennan said, yes, there's definitely a prurient interest, even though it's a specific subcategory of people that were being targeted by this particular material. The prurient interest was still there, and therefore we had obscenity. And then number three, must the government show that Mishkin knew the books were obscene? And Justice Brennan said, yes, they do need to show he knew the material was obscene. And the justice held that clearly the defendant had been disguising his efforts to publish the materials, but the sheer quantity of it showed that he knew that the material was obscene. So his sentence was upheld. Materials were found obscene and not covered by the First Amendment.
This case is also dealing with freedom of speech, I believe, and obscenity or obscenity, whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Don't get at me, y'all.
I don't remember how he was arrested, but he got arrested because he had obscene books, like, in his own possession. And they found that it was obscene, and I had to look into it to see what it was, because in the TikTok they don't say what it was. But I found an article here. It said where the material is designed for and primarily group rather than a public at large. Hold on, I'm trying to find the sentence. Where the material is designed for and primarily disseminated to a clearly defined deviant sexual group. So, like, it was something sexual that was very devious. I don't know. Says to the prurient interest in sex of members of that group. Like,
I don't play with kids. So
I don't think it was child. Like, I don't think it had anything to do with kids. I think
because they would have said child.
Yeah, it would have said it. Like, some crazy stuff.
Girl, they lucky they not in the Twitter era.
Listen, everybody will be in jail.
Everybody will be in jail. All right, so what we giving him?
I mean, not guilty. Like, that's his kink. I don't know.
It was his personal books. He didn't share nothing.
Yeah, I'm going to say not guilty. I mean, the only thing that I think of with the magazines, like, for when they show, like, naked women and stuff, like, if the women are consenting, okay. But then I'm like, any kid can get their hands on it, and that's, like, a little bit. But if he's keeping the books on his shelf in his office, I don't really care. Like, what he's going to say, he's sorry that he's attracted to women. And
I think it's hard for me to really decide, because I would need to know the content of the photos. Like, I would need to know what is it exactly.
Yeah, because it doesn't really specify what kind it is. It's not children, but is it
Oh, children, like, it would have already been closed, the gate locked.
Like, yeah, it would have said if it was like child pornography, but if what if it's like reenacting, you know, and but, stuff.
And you know,
a lot is like that.
Probably I'm reaching, like probably he didn't commit no crime. I don't know. I need to know the content of the photos. So I'm a little undecided. I'm not going to lie. So I guess it's 2 not guilty, 1 undecided. All right.
You can't, you got to decide.
I'm a judge. Not judges.
Yeah.
Not judges be leaving hung cases and shit.
Okay, that's true. Recess.
It's at recess.
A mistrial. So, Supreme Court case law says schools don't need probable cause to search students, but does it say they can strip search them? In Safford v. Redding, a principal accused a 13-year-old student of distributing pills around the school. They searched her locker, her belongings, and couldn't find the pills, so they ordered that she be strip searched. They made her remove her clothing. Unlike the student in the case we're talking about, she was allowed to keep her bra and underwear on, but had to pull them out so they could look and see if there were any pills in them, which to me is still sexual assault. The search in this case was deemed unconstitutional because the school had no reason to believe that the pills would be in her underwear. It wasn't, unfortunately, that strip searching a child was wrong. It was that you didn't have any reason to believe the pills would be in there. In theory, this law then says that that kind of search would be justified if they did have reason to believe they were in there, which I don't think exists in the case currently that we're talking about.
This case has to do with the Fourth Amendment, which if I'm not mistaken, also y'all please do y'all research and double check because your boy don't really dips and dabs into the law stuff unless I'm watching Law and Order SVU. But the Fourth Amendment is basically like the amendment that say like you have the right to not be searched by like the cops or nothing, like without probable cause. So like nobody could just go and fill up on you and shit and try to look for shit like that. But yeah, this girl, I think her name was Savannah Redden. And in 2000, I think the case was decided in 2009, but this happened in 2003, if I'm not mistaken. And basically there was some pill pushing going on at the school. And there was a student that had took some pills or whatever and got sick. They were in pain, I believe. The pills were given the student by some girl, but the girl said that she got the pills from Savannah Redden. And they were ibuprofen, just like high milligram ibuprofen pills. The school is basically like, okay, like now we're going to check you for the pills or whatever. But they really make her, they really made her strip for real. Like her whole, like from what they said, it was like her whole twat and everything.
Underwear, bra.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like that ridiculous at that point. Like y'all are not cops. Y'all are not like, that's the first thing that got me.
That case was crazy. They had her take out her underwear.
I was like,
we want to see if she's hiding in her underwear. Like, come on.
Like, the first thing that went through my mind with that case was, oh my God, had that been today, and then she could have been online. Like she would have been all over social media. Probably for good reasons. That probably could have been good evidence for her to use in a case, but she could have also been 80 times more humiliated than she was back then. Especially if she wasn't, because I don't think she was doing any pill pushing. I think the finger was just pointed at her. And yeah. Did that like textbook definition of searching somebody without fucking probable cause. And sometimes when we watch a Law and Order, when we know the niggas did it, we don't mind them getting searched without probable cause. Cause shit, we know you did it. I understand needing to be solid on it because that's ridiculous. That was and some girl, I think the TikTok I showed y'all, she referred to it as sexual assault. That is sexual assault, if you ask me.
And it's like a bunch of adults. Like, no one said, oh, no, this is wrong.
Yes, and if a man touched her, automatic motherfucking jail time. Are you kidding
no
me?
No one thought, like, this is a little too much out of all the adults that helped make that decision.
Nobody thought y'all was wilding the f*** out. Like, yo, that's ridiculous. My thing is, what could have y'all done? Y'all are not cops. Y'all don't got weapons on y'all. Like, y'all have no training.
The most they will do, what, is expel or something? Like, suspend?
Y'all have no training in apprehending somebody even doing that. Like, what the f- was the gag?
And I feel like even then, like when you see stuff like that, whether you're on TV or even in real life, if a school suspects anything, they're going to call the police. You really don't have any right or training to even go that route and search
at all. You're right, they would have called the cops first. What would y'all would have done if y'all was a girl?
If I was a girl, I would not I mean, how old was she at the time?
13, 14. And that makes it worse. To lie,
yeah. God. I think she was probably like scared or something and just did what they said. Okay, at 13 or 14, I would have, no, I'm about to call my mother. Like, what you mean I got to take off my clothes?
Like, she was high in pills and her.
Oh, so right. Like, this is jail. Like, this is prison. Like, what?
The only prison, I think, is the only place where, like, you would really have to get shit down dirty.
Were you strip search? This is not prison.
I don't know. I mean, it's like, if they had the authority back then to tell me to do that, I don't know.
Because you also got to think about the type of person she is. You know, a lot of kids are different. Some kids are outspoken and would have probably been like, no. Mm-hmm. And some kids, like, you know, they listen to authority. They're going to do it, or they might be scared, or they want to get it over with. No, not knowing that they don't have to do it, but they always listen to, you know, their teachers. That's like a power thing. Like,
yeah,
it's like they took advantage of their, you know, their position.
First of all, I would have objected to all of that. I would have definitely been like, absolutely the not. Like you said, let me call my parent or something.
Yeah,
I'm not doing that. And if I can't call my parent, whatever, like if I was really putting like a situation where I was pressured or whatever, I would have did my pockets, took off my shoes, but I'm not stripping myself. Like, y'all are not about to see titties, rolls. Y'all are-
And it's embarrassing. Like,
that's ridiculous. That's
embarrassing.
And I don't think
the court decided that the school didn't have probable cause. So it's like, even with probable cause, why are you strip searching a child?
Beforehand, it wasn't ruled in her favor. They actually agreed with the school because of qualified immunity. They was like, the teachers had qualified immunity to do what they did. But then she got it appealed from what I heard, alleged. She got it appealed and then they was like, no, qualified immunity don't stand here. Like, they had no reason to do what they did. It was unconstitutional. And it got, and like, you know, the case got turned back in the girl's favor, as it motherfucking should. What we giving them?
They're gonna get barred from teaching ever again.
Yes, I would have sued all hell.
I wouldn't even feel comfortable doing that as a teacher, as an adult. I don't feel comfortable strip searching a child.
Yeah.
Whose idea was that?
No, my mom would have raised hell, bitch. Told me she was on the way. Everybody in that school was motherfucking getting it. Kids would have knew my motherfucking name. With that being said, how did y'all like it?
This is very new, and I've been really into, like, well, I've been into crime cases lately, and I, so, like, kind of like y'all SVU thing, but I'd be watching the real deal, like, murders.
Like, I'm not really y'all SVU girlies. I consider real life stuff.
I know it's based on true events, but I'd be watching the real, like, the interrogation is all very interesting to me. So
yeah, I watched the same too.
Coffee's a whole lawyer. To lie! We need to make this a permanent game for the episode.
We should do criminal cases.
Criminal cases. All right. Savage Code going to be a permanent thing. We just got to look at some cases because y'all coming back on. Yeah. So please get some cases.
Men in America, do better.
Men in America, do better. The links in my description will guide y'all a long motherfucking way, all right? Stay tuned for the music that I'm going to be having coming out soon. And stay tuned. Keep track with Kina and Tati. You guys will definitely see them on episodes in the future. All right, y'all.
Thank you.
There's a difference between hearing and listening. You get it. Our passion, our spirit, our devotion. We're making magic.